Hello everyone. Now we look into another case in sections of solids, which is true shape given problems. So in that, true shape of the section will be given. From that information, we have to draw the section plane. So section plane inclination will not be given in this case. From the true shape, we have to find out the orientation of section plane. So in that case, first we will consider a problem. Problem is like this. This is one of the important problem in this case. Say question is like this. A cube of side 40 mm is cut by a section plane inclined to HP and perpendicular to VP, such that the true shape of the section is a regular hexagon. Draw the front view, sectional top view, and true shape of the section. Also find inclination of the section plane with HP. So this is the problem in which the information is given that the section plane is inclined to HP and perpendicular to VP, but the inclination is not given. Then the other information we have is that the true shape of the section is a regular hexagon. So from a cube, how will we obtain the true shape as a regular hexagon? Say we will see that. Here, this is an important problem. You can say by heart this case, because for a cube, you will get a regular hexagon by cutting a cube only in one way. So we just follow these methods. We just draw the XY line. And draw the cube in such a way that the sides are equally inclined to VP. You have to draw the cube in such a way the sides are equally inclined to VP. For that, just take a 45 degree. So side of the cube as 40 mm. Draw the side of the cube as 40 mm. Place your protractor. Say take 90 degree. Side always say this is 14. Complete this. So since this is the top view of the cube, so here we can give the corners or the face of the cube with proper name. This is A, the top face of the cube is A, B, C, D. See, I will draw a cube here. Suppose this is a cube. Here the name A, B, C, D, and bottom face we can give P, Q, R, S. So here bottom face is also there, you have to name accordingly. P, Q, R, S. Now just draw the front view. Just draw the front view of the cube. Since the side is 40 mm, front view you have to take height as 40 mm. Now name it. This point is A dash. Here it is D dash in bracket B dash. This is C dash. Bottom face are R dash. This is S dash, Q dash. Here it is P dash. Now, for getting a regular hexagon from a cube, you have to cut the section plane. You have to pass the section plane through the exact center of the cube. So, for that, you just mark here the midpoint of each side in top view. Suppose the midpoint, as you know, the side is 40 mm. We can mark the midpoint like this at 20 mm. Now, at this one midpoint, you just project it to the top face. One midpoint, just project it to the top face. Now, another midpoint, just project it to the bottom face. So, what I did is, you see, I just marked a midpoint of the base edge in top view on both sides. Now I just project this point to the top side, top face of the cube. See, this side I mark, and here from this I just project it to the bottom face. So I got 2 points. Now you can construct a section plane by joining those 2 points. You see, simply join those 2 points to get the section plane. This is the section plane to get a regular hexagon in a cube. Now, as you know, this is these arrows. Here, you just name the cutting points. You just name the cutting points. As you know, here, I will give as a 1 dash cutting point. Then, this point is 2. Here it is 3. But this 1 dash is on, you have to remember, this 1 dash is on point. 1 dash point is on line PS. See, here I got 1 dash. This is the point 1 dash. Behind to this 1 dash, there is another line which is PQ. So, in PS I got 1 and PQ there is another point. So, we will get that point from, say, this way. See, here I mark 3. 3 is on point DC. This is 3. Behind that DC, there is another edge which is BC. So that we have to mark 4 dash here. Similarly, 4 will come here. See, this point 2 will be here. Behind 2, there will be another 0.5. So in bracket I can put 5 dash. Similarly, 1 dash with 1 dash, another point is there, that is 6 dash. So this is 6 dash. So these are the 6 points. Say, while joining these 6 points, I will get a hexagonal shape. But this hexagon, I can view this hexagon only when I look perpendicular to the section plane. So that in the true shape only I can see that hexagon. So this is the direction of view. If I look this cut plane in this direction, I can see the section as a regular hexagon. So now in top view also I will mark the cutting points. You see, this point, two points on PS, you have 1, and PQ you have 6. Similarly, this 5, 2 and 5 here, this is point 2. Sorry, I'll use another color to mark that. This is 1, this is 2, this point is 2. For 3 and 4, I just project here. This will be 3, this will be 4 and 5 will be here. You see why this? I got the section points. Now just join all these points. Simply join all these points. You have the section. But what you got is a sectional top view. In this case, this is not a regular hexagon. To get the regular hexagon, you have to draw the true shape of this section. See, if I extend this sectional top view to this much length, I will get a true shape. So let us do that. Just extend this XY line a little bit. Extend this XY line and take the distance of the section plane. Take the distance of the section plane using a compass. 1, 2, 3, 4. This much distance I have to take. See, this much distance. Just mark it here. See, and one more point is here. This 2, 5 also I have to mark. This is 2, 5. So I got those points. As you know, this is 1 (6). This is 2 (5). This is 3 (4). Now we can draw the true shape. You see. Just draw the perpendicular projectors on each point. Here, horizontal projectors from each point. Always remember, while drawing these horizontal projectors, this will be on a single projector. This 6 and 4 will be on a same projector. 1, 3 will be on the same projector. Now, we just mark the section points here. Here, this will be 1. This is your 2. It is 3, 4. Then 5, this is 6. Now just join all those points to get the true shape. You see, now I got a true shape, and this is a regular hexagon. All sides of the this hexagon should be equal. Now you can hatch it, as in the previous cases you can hatch it. You see. Okay. Now here it is asked the inclination of the section plane. Here you can find from this front view, this is around 55. This inclination is around 55. So inclination in this case, inclination of section plane with HP is equal to 55 degree. So that is the answer. In this case, you have to remember one thing. So as I said earlier, true shape is actually the extended figure of the sectional top view. Here you got the sectional top view as a, say, a shortened or shrunk image of this true shape. So this much is the sectional top view. To get the true shape, I just extend or enlarge up to the length of the section plane. So one thing here remains unchanged, that is the distance on the top view. See, the distance 3-4 in this top view, sectional top view, and the true shape will be same. Similarly, all the distance on the top view, the vertical distance on the top view, will be remained same in the true shape also. That is one of the important information you have to solve these kinds of true shape given problems. All the vertical distance in the top view will be remained same in true shape also. The section plane length is actually the length of the true shape. The length of the section plane will serve as the length of the true shape. This is the information from this type of problems.